Ameloblastoma is a benign, slow-growing, locally invasive tumour primarily developing in the mandible's bone structure. Ameloblastoma originates from the odontogenic epithelium, specifically the ameloblasts, which are responsible for forming the tooth enamel. Typically, after enamel development, these cells undergo programmed cell death. However, in ameloblastoma, they abnormally proliferate. Ameloblastoma is quite rare and primarily affects adults between the ages of 30 and 50, with a slight male predominance. Ameloblastoma can be categorized based on both its location and its microscopic appearance. With regards to the anatomical classification, there is the intraosseous type, which means inside the bone, and there's also the extraosseous type, which means outside the bone. The intraosseous type can be further subdivided into the conventional type, which is usually invasive and multicystic, as well as the unicystic type, which is the less aggressive lesion. Then we move outside the bone to the extraosseous type, which arise in the soft tissues overlying the gingiva or alveolar mucosa. These are typically less common than the intraosseous variants. In addition to the anatomical classification, there is also the histological classification, which has six types. These include the follicular type, plexiform, acanthomatous, granular cell, desmoplastic, and basal cell. Diagnosing ameloblastoma often starts with a clinical examination. The initial signs might include facial asymmetry, swelling, or pain in the jaw. A thorough oral examination can sometimes reveal a bony expansion. The next step involves panoramic radiography, highlighting the lesion's soap bubble or honeycomb appearance. For a detailed 3D perspective, cone beam computed tomography, or CBCT, is used. This usually reveals the lesion's extent and its relation to the surrounding structures. If further clarity is needed about the tumor's boundaries or bony invasion, MRI and CT scans might be incorporated. The definitive diagnosis comes from a biopsy, where a tissue sample is examined microscopically. When managing ameloblastoma, our primary line of action is surgical. Enucleation targets smaller lesions, removing the tumor along with a sliver of surrounding healthy tissue. For larger or aggressive tumors, resection is our go-to, which might entail removing a portion of the jawbone, sometimes followed by reconstructive grafting. Marsupialization is another technique. This usually involves creating an opening in the cystic lesion, allowing it to shrink over time. It is typically a preliminary step, reducing the tumor size before a more definitive surgical approach. To summarize, ameloblastoma is a benign, slow-growing, but locally invasive tumor originating from the ameloblasts in the odontogenic epithelium. It is most prevalent in adults between the ages of 30 and 50, with a slight prevalence in males. There are two main anatomical classifications. Intraosseous ameloblastomas, which develop within the bone and are typically more aggressive, and peripheral or extraosseous ameloblastomas, which form in the soft tissues overlying the gingiva or alveolar mucosa, and these are relatively less common and less aggressive. Intraosseous ameloblastomas can be further subdivided into conventional and unicystic types. From a histological viewpoint, the six classifications include follicular, plexiform, acanthomatous, granular cell, desmoplastic, and basal cell types, each showcasing distinct cellular structures and patterns. Diagnosis involves clinical examination, imaging like panoramic radiography, CBCT, MRI, and CT scans for detailed perspectives, with a biopsy serving as a definitive diagnostic tool. Management is primarily surgical, with techniques like enucleation and resection based on the tumor's size and aggressiveness. Marsupialization serves as a prelude, allowing a reduction in size of the tumor before definitive surgical intervention.